Hey guys, I'm Ajinkya Dixit and this is my channel Ajinks Artist. Today I'm at a very special place. Today I'm in search of ODKF, that is right, Oriental Dwarf Kingfisher. It's not technically a kingfisher, but it's a semi-kingfisher. So I've been looking for this bird for around 4 years and I'm hoping today I'll finally get a chance to see this bird and its secret life.
Hey guys, so like I said, I've been chasing this bird for almost 4 years now, probably more. Initially, I just saw this bird and I was like, yes, I want to see this in real life. But it's really hard and this is how the story goes. Let's start this from the beginning. We are talking about the Oriental Dwarf Kingfisher. And it is also known as a black-backed kingfisher or a three-toed kingfisher because it has three toes instead of four like in other birds. This is not entirely a kingfisher, so it is called as a dwarf kingfisher because it can feed on other crustaceans like crabs, even some lizards, snails, spiders and whatnot. Very versatile, and it's a migratory bird.
Hey guys, we've been waiting for the bird for some time now, but no luck yet. Let's see if we get to find it.
I think I struggled a lot because initially I didn't have this lens, my Sigma 150-600mm. This is the beast. I got it in January and since then it's been quite a good experience for me. I did a lot of birding till February end. And in March it was, of course, lockdown all over the world. But luckily, there are a lot of birds around my house. So I got to see a lot of variety of birds in the morning and evening. And even got featured on the CN Travelers website for window birding in Pune. So check that out in the description, that article is there. And let me know your thoughts about my photos. You can also follow me on Instagram. You'll find ODKF photos and other birding photos as well. Okay, so when you start into wildlife or birding, it's not very inclusive kind of structure or society or group of people, photographers, because one thing, nobody wants the same shot. There's a bit of tension slash competition amongst photographers, wildlife particularly, I can say that because this is what happened initially when I started looking for this bird. And I started seeing posts every monsoon, I remember around 2-3 years back. They were so amazing, like so picture perfect photos that you can't believe them. Like they are taken in the studio or in the wildlife. But later as I contacted people, they started telling me the same thing that we cannot tell you the location, we cannot disclose it. We want to keep it private and the bird is very elusive and it gets scared very quickly, so it won't come back next year. And there are a lot of reasons actually which photographers can give and usually do give. And some of them were nice, they would tell general locations like go towards Tamini and there are a lot of streams and you may find somewhere. But nobody would actually tell you specific locations. And it's understandable now. Nobody was willing to tell me where they would find the bird. No streams, no locations. Even no rough idea of where I can find them easily or which direction I should go. And it's fine now because now I've found it, of course. But back then it felt very bad and very disappointed. So one of my friends actually told me that there are setups for this bird. People could actually see them in their backyards every year during the monsoon. So now it has been a while, people have started doing setups in their backyards as well or close to the nesting grounds of the ODKF. There's a nesting area close to a stream and you know for sure around this time, on this perch, the ODKF will be seen. The person who is operating the setup would create a mesh, like a green cloth around that area, put in a shade behind it, maybe some chairs or stools, and you just have to go there, pay that guy, set up your camera and chill. Whenever the bird comes, you just fire up your shots, because it's all set, and that's how you get picture perfect studio shots, which initially blew my mind. There is not a lot of fun in this. I mean, where is the adventure? You just go there, you set up a camera and take photos. I mean, the light is set, there is all cloudy and dark, so high ISO, low shutter speed, you're on a tripod, you can actually use a remote cable, remote release, so you don't even have to touch the camera, you just press the remote and the camera does the rest of it. And there is post-production for it as well, where you clean up all the background and it's plain green color, which brightens up the bird even more. Then you'll get all kinds of shots, you'll get the pair, you'll get the hunting and whatnot. A few friends suggested me I can try that, but I never felt like doing it, and that's probably a last resort for me. If I wouldn't have found this bird, I mean, that there's no fun. Like, it's sitting in my house and clicking pictures through the window, it's the same thing. I'll just have to travel a few miles away from the city. There's some sort of artificial feeling to it that nobody likes. So the ODKF is a migratory bird, as I said before. Comes in from Sri Lanka, most probably towards India, the Western Ghats, and finds a nice stream, would dig up a hole and create a nest around a meter or so deep. On the banks of the stream, probably close to abundance of food and other females as well. Usually, I'm not sure if they come back to the same place where they are born, but they find something similar all along the Western Ghats. So here, close to Pune, I wasn't hoping to find this bird so close to Pune actually, but I did, and I'm very thankful for it. The male would find food and then offer it to the female. The female accepts it and they mate. This happens every year. Yeah, probably new females every year. Lucky guy. The female lays the eggs. The male would go around finding food, feed the female, and then the chicks, they would all grow together, maybe one or two batches of eggs, and then they fly off again till the monsoon probably ends. So in the morning, we were all set up waiting for this bird. It was 45 minutes easily. We were just sitting there and nothing was happening, because there was no activity of any other bird here, and we were really hoping that it would show up, and it did. Yes, yes, yes. A couple of times dipped into the water, and that was a very unique and unseen version of this bird, because usually people find this bird hunting or around the nesting area looking for food, but I'm sure nobody has seen or even filmed the bird taking a bath and preening later. So this is something very rare that I believe I have, or we have found out. It was an amazing sight, and I think almost hour and a half I was observing this bird very closely, and looking at the bird, I can say it's probably a female. There is a nice differentiator between these two, very little difference, but we can differentiate if we observe them quite well. So the female is slightly bigger, it has a rufous head, and I think the back is slightly more bluish, if I'm not wrong. I had no idea about how this bird would react. I had no idea if it would stay there, because I had never observed this bird. I was looking at it for the first time, and it was so hard to believe that finally the efforts have paid off. It's right in front of me. I mean, it's hardly this big, but when you see it flying, it's like a bullet or an arrow that smears across so fast that you only see the colors flashing by. It's a great experience to watch this bird, and I'm very, very thankful. a big shout out to Akshay who told me the location. He said that you should be able to find it in this area probably, and I went with my other friends to explore there, and we all were blessed with this site.
Akshay has managed to get again another awesome clip towards the end there. Dip, he just missed it by a little, but if you watch it in slow-mo, it's so spectacular. Great job, Akshay. Thank you for sharing with us.
It was a great and thrilling experience. I don't believe my luck has finally turned around with this bird particularly.
Oh yes, another update I almost forgot. We are very close to 1000 subscribers, so if you haven't already subscribed, I mean 90% of the viewers are still not subscribed to the channel. Imagine what number that would be. So please subscribe to the channel if you see my efforts in the videos. I've really worked hard on these videos and I really enjoy them. I'm not saying that I would like a lot of subscribers, but at least 1000 should be there because that's what YouTube demands. And so please, we are very close, almost I think less than 60, 70 are remaining. So hit that subscribe button and it's very easy, very free. You can do it anytime, anywhere. Just click it. Thank you. So I hope you enjoyed the video. This was a great first experience for me, and say hi to me on Instagram. I'm mostly active there, rarely on Twitter, but yes, definitely Instagram. All my photos will be posted there and some of the videos as well. So I'll see you next time. Please subscribe to my channel. Bye bye. Thank you.